In the count, if I repeat, we were writing these criterias again and again, which becomes very tedious in case if you have 100 columns to work on. So the best way out of working on the 100 column is you can very easily use count if s and get your result in very less time. You know, but be sure about the formula. It may look like very cumbersome, but if you're very careful, I don't think this will give you any result. But check the formula once again. It's count if s bracket b2 to b6 comma, and in quotes I have this condition, and then comma, I have another range c2 to c6 comma, in the quotes I have another condition which I have got over here. So let's see what result I get over here. Hey, I got 2, because indeed if you see, there are only 2 people who are having yes both in Q1 and in Q2. If you see for C, he is having yes, but he's having no in Q1. And for D and for E, both are having N, that is no. So the result is 2, and I hope you have got the same result when you were doing on your own. All right. So I hope it was clear to you. And I'll give you more questions for the practice to you. And I want to go with the what if analysis now, because I want you guys to work on the practice and submit to me as an assignment. I hope it was easy and clear. So next is, let me do one more and then I will give you another question. So why don't you do it? So the question is that how many times and write how many times D and I'll write it for you. So the question is, how many times, let's say any salesperson, maybe C and E, because we haven't given them any chance. So let me give them a chance. C and E have seeded the same quota seeded the same quota means the Q1, Q2 and the Q3 have exceeded the same quota for the period Q1, Q2 and Q3 have exceeded the same quota for the period Q1, Q2 and Q3, right? Now read the question very carefully. It says how many times C and E have exceeded the same quota for the period of Q1 to Q3. Now your focus has to be only on the C, this A4 and A6, which is having the information regarding C and E. Right, so you are not going to work on the other areas, but you're going to focus only on your this particular column. So try doing that, and I want to work with the goals seek analysis, because that is thing that is wanted to complete in this class, and I'll give you more exercise for count if and count if s, because it requires you practice. You know, only when you do more, you will understand more. And you will, you know, get results right in the first go. Otherwise, without practice, you will see yourself struggling with the data. So that was all for the count if and count if s. We will do some more functions because I just don't want to have a class only with the functions. So you will normally find me, doing some functions and some more other concepts that are there in the units that we are going to do further.